If you are new to my channel and want to educate yourself more about herpes viruses, please like my videos and subscribe to my channel. Make sure to ring on the notification bell so that you'll be the first to watch my uploaded videos every day. Let's put an end to the herpes virus.
Hsv1 2 IgG positive and IgM negative. Blood tests can be used when a person has no visible symptoms but has concerns about having herpes. Blood tests do not actually detect the virus, instead, they look for antibodies, the body's immune response, in the blood. IgM versus IgG. When an individual contracts herpes, the immune system responds by developing antibodies to fight the virus, IgG and IgM. Blood tests can look for and detect these antibodies, not the virus itself. IgG appears soon after infection and stays in the blood for life. IgM is actually the first antibody that appears after infection, but it may disappear thereafter. IgM tests are not recommended because of three serious problems. Many assume that if a test discovers IgM, they have recently acquired herpes. However, research shows that IgM can reappear in blood tests in up to a third of people during recurrences, while it will be negative in up to half of persons who recently acquired herpes but have culture document first episodes. Therefore, IgM tests can lead to deceptive test results, as well as false assumptions about how and when a person actually acquired HSV. For this reason, we do not recommend using blood tests as a way to determine how long a person has had herpes. Unfortunately, most people who are diagnosed will not be able to determine how long they have had the infection. In addition, IgM tests cannot accurately distinguish between HSV1 and HSV2 antibodies, and thus very easily provide a false positive result for HSV2. This is important in that most of the adult population in the US already has antibodies to HSV1, the primary cause of oral herpes. A person who only has HSV1 may receive a false positive for HSV2. IgM tests sometimes cross-react with other viruses in the same family, such as varicella zoster virus, VZV, which causes chickenpox, or cytomegalovirus, CMV, which causes mono, meaning that positive results may be misleading. The accurate herpes blood tests detect IgG antibodies. Unlike IgM, IgG antibodies can be accurately broken down to either HSV1 or HSV2. The challenge here is that the time it takes for IgG antibodies to reach detectable levels can vary from person to person. For one person, it could take just a few weeks, while it could take a few months for another. So even with the accurate tests, a person could receive a false negative if the test is taken too soon after contracting the virus. For the most accurate test result, it is recommended to wait 12-16 weeks from the last possible date of exposure before getting an accurate, type-specific blood test in order to allow enough time for antibodies to reach detectable levels. There are currently several FDA-approved, IgG-based blood tests that can give accurate results for herpes. Like any blood test, these tests cannot determine whether the site of infection is oral or genital. However, since most cases of genital herpes are caused by HSV2, a positive result for type 2 antibodies most likely indicates genital herpes.
Thank you for watching. And please subscribe to my channel for my upcoming herpes treatment videos.